West Virginia and Marshall from Huntington, West Virginia. Due to time constraints, we move ahead in our action. Marshall and West Virginia battling. Each team had only two first downs apiece in the first quarter. Marshall trailing West Virginia 6-3, and Slayton and White, not what you'd expect from these Heisman hopefuls.
No, and they're a little bit, I don't know, off kilter right now, maybe would be the way to put it, but they are an explosive duo, so it's just a matter of getting touches, and eventually they're going to bust a big one. You can count on that.
Slayton, four touches for a grand total of 5 yards. Ken McAfee, a little line drive punt, and that one rolls dead around the 37-yard line. McAfee boomed a 55-yarder earlier in this game. That one only traveled 35. For the Herd. Morris pitches it. Marshall picks it up off the bounce and will lose a couple of yards. The ball is loose again. Antonio Lewis closing in on the ball, but Marshall does not cough it up. That was dangerous. They almost gave it up on their side of the field.
Darius Marshall, actually, when he catches this pitch, thinks he's playing basketball. He's going to dribble it one time, but knocks it down on the ground. That was a heck of a play, but he took a nice shot from Lewis to knock the ball out later on. Bam, right there, the big hit. That was actually Quentin Andrews who made the big hit. Lewis had a hold of him by the legs.
So they dodge some trouble there by not fumbling it away, but another punt. Anthony Binswanger pressed into duty because of two punters who were hurt in the preseason. Normally their place kicker. That's a beauty. Good hang time. Fair catch signaled for and taken by Vaughn Rivers on the 43-yard punt. Pat White and Steve Slayton, like lightning in a bottle. They haven't broken loose yet. Perhaps they will on this series.
White took the job, and there's an old Chinese proverb that if you're ever given something of value, which I was a head football coach at a college at 29 years old, and I thought I could give something back to Marshall in football, and so that's why I took the job.
And of course, you took over the year after the tragic plane crash that basically wiped out the entire football team. What did you think about Matthew McConaughey and the way he portrayed you, and would you say it was an accurate portrayal?
Well, I think Warner Brothers did a good job of telling the whole story, the Marshall story, and Matthew did a good job of bringing the movie together. You know, one night we were on the set and walking back, and he said, you know, Jack, he said, I read all your material and looked at all your playbook and everything, and he said, I internalized it as an actor, and he said, then I didn't try to mimic you, so I tried to play the role. I said, I'm glad you told me that, Matthew, because I was never that animated on the sidelines. And of course, he laughed, but I thought he did a brilliant job in the movie.
And Jack, taking over in those circumstances had to be tough. What was the biggest challenge that you faced?
Well, I think that the biggest challenge was to pull. When I got there, I thought I was rebuilding a football team, and I came quickly to find out there were 24 boosters on that plane, four doctors and their wives, state senators, city councilmen, leaders, dean of admissions, director of athletics, 70 children without one parent and 18 without two parents. And I found out that there was a whole community that was devastated with this crash, and we had a whole town behind us and supporting us in the Big Green, and the community was just absolutely fabulous in the rebuilding. And all we did was lay the foundation. Bobby Pruitt took it to its fruition and had the winningest program in Division 1A 20 years later.
Jack, in the movie, you switched to the Veer and you went up to get your information from Bobby Bowden, and I know that was a big help for you.
Bobby Bowden was the old, we couldn't run our offense. We were running a power offense, and I saw Bobby was running the Houston Veer, and the Houston Veer is a concept offense, so I called Bobby, and Bobby graciously invited our whole staff up there. We spent 3 days with them, Frank Cignetti taught us the offense, went down 3 days later, was learning the offense as we put it in. Bobby Bowden is not only a great coach, he's a great human being, and has been close with our family all these years, but he's a wonderful coach, but he's a better human being.
Yeah, Jack, thank you so much for joining us, and we'll let you go back and enjoy the rest of this game. Marshall's in good field position. Jack Lengel, thanks again.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
The head coach of this Marshall team in 1971 after the terrible plane crash, and portrayed so well in that film, We Are Marshall and Matthews, the one on the right. We just talked to the guy on the left. And it was a heck of a film. Bring your tissues if you're going to see it or buy it. It's coming out a week from Tuesday. And Marshall fans had a lot to cheer about in that last series. And there is the We Are Marshall, the tribute, the Memorial Student Center fountain dedicated in November of 72 to the memory of the crash victims. And the water stops flowing every November 14th, which was the date of that terrible tragedy. But out of the ashes has come a great football program. Morris into the end zone. And it is caught for the touchdown. Darius Passmore with the catch, and Marshall leads this game. So Bernard Morris was very close to the line of scrimmage when he let go of that ball. I don't think Darius Passmore is ever going to give that football up. That's his.
And what a play. When things break down, athletes take over. And Morris did so, buying the extra time. And Passmore, with the speed and the reaction, running deep. And then the perfect throw. And Marshall throws a dagger into the heart of West Virginia here in the second quarter.
Coach Jack Langell made it a good luck charm when we were talking to him. Marshall had a great defensive stop. And then Anthony Binswanger with the extra point. 38-yard touchdown to Passmore, and the Thundering Herd lead.
And great protection that time as Morris watches. Nobody's really getting near him. Nobody close to him. He's got the time, so now he's just going to buy more time. Moving outside, waves his receiver, Passmore, down the field, and just drops it in perfectly right over the top of Vaughn Rivers. And Passmore, he's got the speed. He shows he runs away from Rivers there. And Rivers never got his head turned around to find the football. And that was the key to that play. And great ad lib there by Morris and Passmore. And they are excited.
Bernard Morris with his first touchdown pass of this season. And what a big one it was. He says nobody's been able to stop Passmore in scrimmages or practice, and certainly not on the field on that.